BGMC. The biblical truth lives here.
The ancient Hebrew scriptures foretold of the Anointed One, Yeshua HaMashiach. The Messiah Yeshua came to call the people back to the truth of His word and to follow that righteous path. Yeshua then called Jewish men to be His disciples, and after His death and resurrection, those Jewish men told the world about the Jewish Messiah. Now, after 2,000 years, Beth Goyim Messianic Congregation has that same calling of those Jewish men, telling all people, both Jew and Gentile, about the proper ancient path, teaching the Route 66 King's Highway from Genesis through to Revelation, and how you need and can get back to the proper roots of the faith and a closer walk with God. Now, let's hear the message.
Let's go get a blessing. Amen, welcome amen. To the City Gate Messianic Bible Study.
Bienvenidos al estudio bíblico mesiánico de la puerta de la ciudad.
We're doing parasha number 8 in our series on studying the word.
Estamos estudiando la parasha número 8 en la serie de estudiar la palabra.
Parasha number 8 is called Vayeshlach.
Parasha número 8 se llama Vayeshlach.
It means in Hebrew, and he sent.
Significa en hebreo, y él envió.
Let's go on to the next slide.
Va a la próxima diapositiva.
We're once again in the City Gate Messianic Bible Study.
Nuevamente estamos en el estudio bíblico mesiánico, la puerta de la ciudad.
Parasha number 8 has two main, well, there's a lot. Well, two main points.
Hay dos puntos principales en el parasha número 8.
There is a lot of information in this parasha.
Hay mucha información en este parasha.
But what we're doing in this series of studies,
lo que estamos haciendo en esta serie de estudios,
is we're taking one main concept.
Es que estamos tomando un concepto principal.
Or the concept that you need to understand for this parasha.
O más bien el concepto que debes de entender para este parasha.
And the main concept, there's two main concepts.
Hay dos conceptos principales.
The one is trusting.
Uno es confiar.
Which is very good for the world that we're living in right now.
Que es muy bueno para el mundo en la cual estamos viviendo ahora.
The main portion is we need to trust God's word.
La porción principal es que necesitamos confiar en la palabra de Dios.
And we need to learn from God's word.
Y necesitamos aprender de la palabra de Dios.
And we need to stop wrestling with God's word.
Y debemos de dejar de luchar contra la palabra de Dios.
That is two of the main points here.
Estos son dos de los puntos principales aquí.
Whether or not you believe that the virus is real or not, which I don't believe it is real.
Aunque pienses que el virus es real o no, pero yo no pienso que es real.
And you can prove that by the numbers.
Tú puedes comprobar eso por los números.
A total of only 5,000 people have died worldwide from the COVID-19.
Un total mundial solamente han muerto 5,000 personas del COVID-19.
And in 2017, 1,600,000 died from tuberculosis.
Y en el 2017, 1,300,000. 1,600,000 personas murieron de tuberculosis.
And there were 10 million cases worldwide.
Y habían 10 millones de casos alrededor del mundo.
And Tom Hanks is already better.
Y Tom Hanks está mejor.
And you know, Mr. Rogers is really a nice guy.
Y sabe que Mr. Rogers es un hombre amable.
Okay. So, but what we're going to learn in tonight's parasha,
lo que vamos a aprender aquí en el parasha de esta tarde,
is about one of our forefathers, Jacob.
Uno de nuestros patriarcas,
yeah, one of
Jacob,
the patriarchs.
Jacob,
he had a problem trusting.
Él tuvo un problema con confiar.
And when you have a problem trusting God's word implicitly.
Cuando tienes un problema de confiar en la palabra de Dios completamente, implícitamente.
Implicitamente. More Italian.
Italiano.
Then what happens is you wrestle inside yourself.
Después lo que sucede es que tú luchas entre ti mismo.
And you wrestle with God.
Y comienzas a luchar con Dios.
And when you wrestle with God, you wrestle with your blessings.
Y cuando tú luchas con Dios, luchas contra tu bendición.
So let's just say I'm wrong.
Vamos a suponer que estoy equivocado.
And this virus is real.
Y este virus es real.
I could be wrong. I'm not God.
Yo me puedo equivocar. Yo no soy Dios.
And let's say millions of people start dying.
Y digamos que millones de personas empiezan a morir.
You're going to be very scared.
Tú vas a estar bien asustado.
Because you don't trust.
Porque no confías.
What's the worst thing that can happen to a believer?
¿Qué es lo peor que le pueda pasar a un creyente?
You die.
¿Mueres?
No, the worst thing is that you live.
Lo peor es que puedas vivir.
You know, because it'd be cool to die.
Porque sería bien el morir.
Because then you go back up to heaven.
Porque entonces regresas al cielo.
Especially if you're following Torah and believing Messiah Yeshua.
Especialmente si estás siguiendo la Torah y creyendo en Yeshua, el Mesías.
But what we're going to see is one of the patriarchs wrestling with God.
Lo que vamos a ver aquí es uno de los patriarcas luchando con Dios.
Wrestling with his trust.
Luchando con su confianza.
And when you wrestle with your trust.
Y cuando luchas con tu confianza.
That's when your life becomes difficult.
Eso es cuando tu vida se vuelve difícil.
And when people don't have a standard of the word of God.
Y cuando la gente no tiene la norma de la palabra de Dios.
And when I say the word of God.
Y cuando digo la palabra de Dios.
It must include the Torah.
Debe de incluir la Torah.
Because that's what sets us apart from evil people.
Porque eso es lo que nos aparta de los malignos.
Because what makes you holy.
Porque lo que nos hace santo.
Is when you become a new creation.
Es cuando viene a ser una nueva creación.
Now God is always going to keep his promises. Jehovah Elohim is going to keep his promises.
Ahora Dios siempre va a guardar sus promesas. Cumplir con sus promesas.
But you can gather your blessings.
Si tú puedes reunir tus bendiciones.
By being obedient.
En el ser obediente.
Or you can have your blessings withheld for disobedience.
O puedes que se detengan tus bendiciones por la desobediencia.
And what we're really going to see in tonight's study.
Y lo que verdaderamente vamos a ver en el estudio de esta tarde.
Is when you wrestle with Yeshua, you get hurt.
Es que cuando tú luchas con Yeshua, te lastimas.
And that pain will never go away for the rest of your life.
Y ese dolor nunca se apartará de ti por toda tu vida.
So let's go on to next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
Vayishlach, parasha number 8.
Vayishlach, parasha número 8.
Is from Bereshit, Genesis chapter 32, verse 4, through chapter 36, verse 43.
Es de Bereshit, Génesis capítulo 32, versículo 4, hasta el capítulo 36, versículo 43.
You literally can spend a month on each one of these chapters.
Literalmente puedes pasar un mes estudiando cada uno de estos capítulos.
There's that much information in this parasha.
Así de tanto hay información en este parasha.
Going on to next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
We're going to go through a summary of those of the entire parasha before we start the two main points.
Vamos a un breve repaso de este parasha antes de comenzar los dos puntos principales.
All right, let's go on to next slide about the summary.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva sobre el repaso.
Now, in the timeline of things going on in the Bible.
En la línea de tiempo de las cosas que están sucediendo en la Biblia.
Jacob is going to return to the land of Canaan.
Jacob va a retornar a la tierra de Canaán.
Now, this is after 20 years.
Esto es después de 20 años.
So he's still. What's interesting is he's still fearful his brother is going to kill him.
Lo que es bien interesante es que él todavía teme de que su hermano lo va a matar.
It was interesting in our theology class this morning.
Era bien interesante en nuestra clase de teología esta mañana.
I asked the kids, how long could you be mad at your brother or sister?
Le pregunté a los niños, ¿cuánto tiempo tú crees que puedes estar enojado con tu hermano o tu hermana?
Most of the children said a day.
La mayoría de los niños dijeron un día.
Some said an afternoon.
Algunos dijeron una tarde.
But there was one kid.
Había un niño
that said they've held a grudge for 7 years.
Que dijeron que guardaron rencor por 7 años.
Because their brother broke their Nintendo.
Porque su hermano le rompió, le quebró su Nintendo.
And they were still mad that the Nintendo was broken.
Todavía estaba enojado de que su Nintendo estaba quebrado.
So 7 years later,
so 7 años después.
Oh, you got it. So what I was doing in the theology class,
lo que estaba haciendo en la clase de teología,
was seeing if people could hold a grudge for 20 years.
A ver si alguien podía guardar rencor por 20 años.
And I mean myself, especially once I got older.
Yo especialmente cuando maduré.
And I didn't see my siblings as much.
Y no veía mis hermanos tanto como antes.
I had a life.
Tenía una vida.
I got a family and everything else like that.
Tuve una familia y cosas así.
So I really didn't care about things when we were children.
So verdaderamente no me molestó las cosas cuando yo era niño.
But Yaakov, while we're talking about this, Yaakov is still afraid of his brother.
De la razón de estamos hablando de esto es porque Jacob todavía temía su hermano.
Because he doesn't trust the Lord at all.
Porque él no confiaba en el Señor.
And this is a good lesson to learn about one of the patriarchs.
Y esto es una lección muy buena en aprender de uno de los patriarcas.
If one of the patriarchs needed to learn about trust,
si uno de los patriarcas necesitaba aprender sobre la confianza,
then it's a lesson that we should all learn.
Entonces debe de ser una lección que toditos debemos de aprender.
But after 20 years, Esau was not still mad with his brother.
Pero después de 20 años, Esaú no le guardaba rencor a su hermano.
And they finally meet one another and they hug and they make up.
Y al fin se encontraron y se abrazaron y remendaron sus diferencias.
Okay, and then another part of the parasha.
Y otra parte de la parasha.
Yaakov then wrestles with this man that comes out of nowhere.
Yaakov comienza a luchar con este hombre que sale de la nada.
He's all alone in the desert.
Él está solo en el desierto.
He sent his four families away.
Él envió sus cuatro familias.
And he's alone.
Y él está solo.
And then out of nowhere, this guy jumps him.
Y de la nada este hombre lo salta y lo agarra.
And then they fight all night long.
Y están luchando la noche entera.
And then finally, this man.
Y finalmente este hombre
strikes his hip, strikes Yaakov's hip.
Le pega a la cadera de Jacob.
And dislocates his leg.
Desloca,
breaks his leg.
Le quiebra la pierna, la cadera.
And then Yaakov holds on to this man.
Entonces Jacob agarra a este hombre.
That we don't know who this man is.
Que no sabemos quién es.
And he says, "I won't let you go until you bless me."
Y él dice, "No te soltaré hasta que me bendigas."
Now, would the Father in heaven?
¿Será que el Padre en el cielo?
Let anybody, any. Just some guy. Would he let just some guy?
¿Permitiría algún hombre
change one of the patriarchs, one of the forefathers' names?
¿Cambiarle el nombre a uno de los patriarcas?
Unless that man happened to be somebody close to God.
Al menos que ese hombre era alguien bien cercano a Dios.
Okay, we're going to look at that a little bit later.
Vamos a mirar eso un poco después.
Then in this parasha, there's Yaakov's daughter Dinah gets raped.
Y entonces después en este parasha, la hija de Jacob, Dina, es violada
by the prince of Shechem.
Por el príncipe de Shechem.
And then he after he's done raping her, he wants to marry her.
Y después que la viola, se quiere casar con ella.
See, this is what happens when you follow the world's ways.
Esto es lo que sucede cuando tú sigues los caminos del mundo.
You get things backwards.
Hace las cosas al revés.
Because usually you get engaged and then you have relations after you get married.
Por lo normal te comprometes y después de que te cases es que viene a tener relaciones.
But the prince of Shechem rapes Yaakov's daughter, his only daughter Dinah.
El príncipe de Shechem viola la única hija de Jacob.
And then he wants to marry her.
Y después él se quiere casar con ella.
But Shimon and Levi say, well, if you guys all get circumcised.
Pero Simón y Levi le dicen a ellos, si todos los hombres se circuncidan,
then you can marry Dinah.
Entonces te puede casar con ella.
And they use the Brit Milah, the circumcision.
So ellos usaron el Brit Milah, la circuncisión,
to trick them into, because it's the third day you're going to be in a lot of pain.
Engañarlos a ellos porque en el tercer día va a tener mucho dolor.
Okay. And Shimon and Levi attack the whole city of men on the third day.
Simón y Levi atacaron a la ciudad entera de los hombres en el tercer día.
And they get their daughter, they get their sister Dinah back.
Y ellos regresan a su hermana Dinah.
Then the final part of the parasha. Not the final part.
no la parte final.
The next part, Raquel dies while giving birth to Benjamin.
En la próxima parte del parasha, Raquel muere dando la luz a Benjamín.
Okay, and she wants to call Benjamin son of my sorrow instead of son of my sorrow.
Y ella quiere llamar a Benjamín hijo de mi tristeza o de mi lamento.
Because Rachel is just such a great woman to be around.
Porque Raquel es tremenda mujer para estar con ella.
But Yaakov says no, his name will be Benjamin, son of my right hand.
Pero Jacob dice no, que su nombre será Benjamín, hijo de mi diestra.
And then finally,
y finalmente,
at the end of this parasha,
al final de este parasha,
Yitzhak, Jacob's father, Yitzhak, dies.
El padre de Jacob, Yitzhak, muere.
Yes, he dies at the end of the parasha. Hold on, we got a coughing fit. Coronavirus. Ah, run. Let me breathe in the kennel.
Let me get my pump.
Now, if you need a good candle to stop the coronavirus, go to avoil.com. Get the cassia candle. Get 2-3. It's medicine from the Bible. That's www.avoil.com. They're not paying us. They're good friends of ours, and the candles smell nice, and they're medicine. Okay. So let's go on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
So now we're going to go through the bullet points of the chapter and the verses that these events happen in.
Okay, vamos a los puntos a donde se encuentran estos eventos en los capítulos y versículos.
Okay. In the first bullet point,
En el primer punto,
and this is happening in Bereshit, Genesis chapter 32, verse 4 through 33.
Esto sucede en Génesis capítulo 32, versículos 4 al 33.
Jacob prepares to meet Esau.
Jacob se prepara a encontrarse con Esau.
By separating the four families.
Separando las cuatro familias.
You're saying four families. What four families?
Tú le dices cuatro familias. ¿Qué cuatro familias?
Remember, he's got two wives and two concubines.
Acuérdate que él tiene dos esposas y dos concubinas.
Okay. And in this first bullet point, he said he wrestles with a man.
Aquí en esta primera parte, él lucha con un hombre.
Who changes his name from Jacob to Israel.
Que cambia en su nombre de Jacob a Israel.
And this happens in chapter 32.
Esto sucede en capítulo 32.
Verse 4 through 33.
Versículos 4 al 33.
Okay, going on to the second bullet point.
En la segunda parte.
Jacob and Esau meet.
Jacob y Esaú se encuentran.
Jacob does not get killed by his brother.
Jacob no es Esaú no mata a su hermano Jacob.
Amazingly, his brother has grown up.
Bien asombrante, su hermano ha madurado.
He's got a couple of wives of his own.
Él tiene un par de esposas propias.
He's got a very successful business.
Tiene un negocio bien exitoso.
Because he's got 400 employees.
Porque tiene 400 empleados.
Okay, because he's got 400 men with him.
Porque tiene 400 hombres con él.
Now, you're not going to get 400 men to come with you unless they're working for you.
400 hombres no van a venir contigo a menos que estén trabajando por ti.
Or you're a king of some sort.
O si a menos que eres rey de alguna parte.
So for 20 years, Jacob was worried about his brother who's going to kill him.
So por 20 años, Jacob estaba preocupado de que su hermano Esaú lo iba a matar.
So what that shows,
lo que eso demuestra,
and we're going to look at this during the rest of the study,
y vamos a ver esto para el resto del estudio,
is he does not trust Jehovah's promises.
Es que él no confía en las promesas de Jehová.
And he also has a guilty conscience.
Y también tiene una conciencia
guilty spirit.
Sí, que tiene un espíritu de culpabilidad.
But in chapter 33, verse 1 through 17,
en el capítulo 33 del versículos 1 al 17,
Jacob and Esau meet and they part peacefully.
Jacob y Esaú se encuentran y se despiden en paz.
Each going their separate way.
Cada uno por su propio camino.
So Esau does not kill his brother.
So Esaú no mata a su hermano.
Even though we had one kid in the class that held a grudge for 7 years.
Aunque tuvimos un niño en la clase que guardó rencor por 7 años.
For 7 years, this kid was mad that the other kid broke the DS.
Estaba enojado de que el otro hermano quebró el Nintendo.
Okay, let's go on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
In the next part, in chapter 34, verse 1 through 31.
En la otra parte, en capítulo 34, versículos 1 al 31.
Dinah is raped by Shechem.
Dinah es violada por el príncipe de Shechem.
Okay. Now you can spend a lot of time just studying this whole event.
Tú puedes pasar mucho tiempo estudiando solamente esta parte.
Because she's raped by Shechem.
Porque ella es violada por el príncipe Shechem.
The son of Hamor.
El hijo de Hamor.
The Hivite.
El Hivite.
Okay, so you can study who that people group is.
So tú puedes estudiar quién es ese grupo de personas.
Who Hamor is. In the prophetic,
quien Hamor es en lo profético,
who Shechem is,
quien Shechem es,
who Dinah is, or
quien,
Dina,
quien es Dina,
okay, where that country was,
a donde estaba ese país,
okay, and who was it, why was he the chief of that country,
y por qué él era el jefe de ese país.
But you can't understand any of this,
pero no puedes entender nada de esto.
Or why this is happening.
O por qué esto está sucediendo.
Until you understand trusting.
Hasta que entiendas el confiar.
And wrestling with the word of God.
Y luchando con la palabra de Dios.
When you wrestle with the word of God, the trials become greater.
Cuando luchas con la palabra de Dios, las pruebas son más grandes.
This is one of the lessons we're really going to focus on. In Parasha number 8.
Esta es una de las lecciones que en verdad nos vamos a enfocar en el Parasha número 8.
And I'm taking time to lead up to that so that you can understand greater.
Y estoy tomando el tiempo para llegar hasta eso para que puedas entender más grande.
So after Dinah or Dina is raped by Shechem.
Después que Dina es violada por Shechem,
Yaakov waits for his sons to return to tell them.
Jacob espera que sus hijos regrese a decírselo.
Their sons overstepped their boundaries.
Los hijos sobrepasaron sus límites.
And this is one of Yaakov's very big shortcomings.
Y este es otro de los
his problems.
De los problemas de Jacob.
Okay, because his sons Shimon and Levi.
Porque sus hijos Simeón y Levi.
They take revenge and murder all the males of Shechem.
Ellos se ven, ellos toman venganza y asesinan a todos los varones de Shechem.
But they use the covenant of the Brit Milah to do it.
Pero usan el pacto del Brit Milah de la circuncisión para hacerlo.
Which is absolutely, positively wrong.
Que es absolutamente y positivamente erróneo.
You don't use something of God to trick your enemy.
Tú no usa algo sagrado que es de Dios para engañar a tu enemigo.
Because God will not approve of this type of behavior.
Porque Dios no aprobaría de este comportamiento.
Okay, so they murder all the males of Shechem.
So asesinaron a todos los barones de Shechem, thank you.
And Yaakov's other sons join them in plundering the city.
Y los otros hijos de Jacob se unen con ellos en saquear la ciudad. Thank you.
So they use, they tell the guys to be circumcised.
Le dicen a los varones que se circunciden.
They wait a couple of days.
Esperan un par de días.
Where the men are all in pain.
A donde los varones están todos adoloridos.
And then they come and fight them when they can't fight back.
Y pelean contra ellos cuando ellos no se pueden defender.
That is not okay.
Eso no está bien.
Let's go on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
Okay, in chapter 35.
Okay, en el capítulo 35.
Verse 16 through 21.
Versículos 16 al 21.
Raquel dies while giving birth to Benjamin.
Raquel muere dando a luz a Benjamín.
Because Benjamins are always a problem.
Porque Benjamins son siempre un problema. You telling me? Hence both of us. Nothing to say now? No.
Benjamins are always a problem.
Los Benjamines siempre son problemas. Cabeciduro.
Okay. And Rachel is buried in Ephrata.
Y Raquel la entierran en Ephrata.
Which is our present day Beit Lehem.
Que es en el presente Belén.
Belén.
Yeah, correct. Belén. I'm over here trying to say Bethlehem in Spanish. Belén.
Then our final bullet point.
Y nuestro punto final.
Yaakov's father Yitzhak dies.
El papá de Jacob, Yitzhak, muere.
And this happens in chapter 35.
Y esto ocurre en el capítulo 35.
Verse 22 to chapter 36, verse 43.
Versículos versículos 22. Al capítulo 36, versículo 44.
And Yitzhak is buried in Hebron, which is there still to today.
Y Yitzhak está enterrado en Hebrón, que todavía existe hoy en día.
All right, so let's get down to the, let's go to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
And we're going to once again focus on the main points, two main points of this parasha.
Y nuevamente vamos a enfocarnos en los dos puntos principales de este parasha.
But because you can't understand Rachel,
porque
Raquel.
Porque no puedes entender a Raquel.
You know, and her death wish, you know, her deathbed wish.
Y su deseo final.
You know, wanting to call Benjamin Benoni instead of Benjamin.
Que el querer llamar a Benjamín Benoni en vez de Benjamín.
You know, son of my sorrow instead of You know, that's what you want to call with your last breath, call your kid.
Eso es lo que quería llamar a tu nombrar a tu hijo, hijo de mi lamento en vez de hijo de mi diestra.
You can't understand this until you understand trust.
No puedes entender esto hasta que entiendas el confiar.
You can't understand this until you understand fighting with God.
No puedes entender esto hasta que entiendas el luchar con Dios.
You can't understand Jacob fighting with the angel or fighting with the man.
No puedes entender Jacob luchando con el ángel o luchando con el hombre.
Until you understand this trusting.
Hasta que entiendas el confiar.
Or you can't understand why he's wrestling with the word if he got a promise. You can't understand why he's wrestling with the word and when he got a promise.
O no puedes entender el por qué él estaba luchando con la palabra cuando él recibió la promesa.
That's what people don't understand.
Eso es lo que la gente no entiende.
You know, a lot of people have been asking me lately, you know, what's going to happen to the country?
Mucha gente me han preguntado últimamente qué va a suceder con el país.
I always say this when they're talking about our president.
Siempre digo esto cuando están hablando sobre nuestro presidente.
And is this the final end of this nation?
Si este es el final de esta nación.
There's a promise that God gave.
Hay una promesa que Dios dio.
In Bereshit, Genesis chapter 12.
En Bereshit, Génesis capítulo 12.
Where he said, I'll bless those that bless Israel.
Que dijo, bendeciré a quien te bendiga, a Israel.
And as long as President Trump blesses the Jewish people.
Y por este... Mientras el presidente Trump siga bendiciendo al pueblo judío,
we're still gonna have blessings in this nation.
Todavía vamos a tener bendiciones en esta nación.
You saw what the last president did.
¿Viste lo que el último presidente hizo?
So, but this lack of trust actually comes from men in the Bible.
Pero esta falta de confianza viene de hombres en la Biblia.
So then picture people without the word of God.
Entonces piensa en gente sin la palabra de Dios.
You know, I was very struck by an email that my wife got the other night.
Estuve asombrado sobre un correo electrónico que mi esposa recibió las otras noches.
From a messianic believer that lives in Eretz Israel.
De un creyente mesiánico que vive en la tierra de Israel.
She was remarking on how many of the messianic believers are afraid about what's going on.
Ella estaba comentando de cómo los creyentes mesiánicos tenían miedo de lo que estaba sucediendo.
Why should you be afraid?
¿Por qué debes de temer?
You're living in the land.
Estás viviendo en la tierra.
You believe in Yeshua.
Crees en Yeshua.
Maybe you're not following the Torah.
Tal vez no estás siguiendo la Torah.
See, if you believe in Messiah,
ves, si crees en el Mesías,
and you walk in his footsteps. Hold on a second, we're going to change batteries. Un momento, por favor.
Mana.
See, if you're walking in Yeshua's footsteps,
si estás caminando en las huellas de Yeshua,
then you won't wrestle with the word of God.
Entonces no vas a luchar con la palabra de Dios.
And you'll trust.
Y vas a confiar.
You know, there's a lot of stuff going on here in America.
Hay muchas cosas que están sucediendo aquí en América.
I mean, you go to the supermarkets right now.
Vas a los supermercados ahora.
The shelves are empty.
Las repisas están vacías.
People are staying home.
La gente se están quedando en sus casas.
So their finances are going to go low.
So sus finanzas van a bajar.
And things are going to transpire in a very bad way.
Y las cosas van a transcurrir en una manera muy mala.
But if you have faith,
si tienes fe,
and you trust in your faith,
y confías en esa fe,
and you trust in the promises of God,
y confías en las promesas de Dios,
and even if somebody says they're going to kill you,
y aunque alguien diga te van a matar,
you don't worry about that.
Tú no te preocupas de eso.
Because Jehovah gives you signs and he gives you a promise.
Porque Yeshua te da señas y te da una promesa.
So if you learn anything from today's study,
si retienes algo de este estudio de esta tarde,
see, the Bible is an incredible book.
La Biblia es un libro increíble.
Because it gives you real life examples on how you should act and how you shouldn't act.
Porque te da ejemplos reales de cómo debes de comportarte y cómo no debes.
And what we're going to see here is in this parasha number 8.
Y lo que vamos a ver aquí en este parasha número 8
is how you should not act.
Es como no debes de actuar.
Because when you act this way,
porque cuando actúas de esta forma,
you get a stinky life.
Te recibes una vida ufa.
But if you trust,
dolorosa. When you cuando confías,
then you don't wrestle with God.
Entonces no luchas con Dios.
Let's go on to next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
Turn in your Bibles to Bereshit Genesis chapter 32.
Abran sus Biblias a Génesis capítulo 32.
And the translator needs another cup of coffee. And we're going to look at verse 2 through 8.
Y vamos a mirar versículos 2 al 8.
Genesis 32, verse 2 through 8.
Génesis capítulo 32, versículos 2 al 8.
Bereshit 32, verse 2 through 8.
Génesis capítulo 2, capítulo 32, versículos 2 al 8.
Yaakov went on his way, and the angels of God met him. When Yaakov saw them, he said, "This is God's camp," and called that place Machanaim, which means two camps. Yaakov sent messengers ahead of him to Esau, his brother, toward the land of Seir, the country of Edom. With these instructions, here's what you are to say to my lord Esau. Your servant Yaakov says, "I have been living with Laban, and have stayed until now. I have cattle, donkeys, and flocks, and male and female servants. I am sending to tell you this news to my lord in order to win your favor." The messengers returned to Yaakov saying, "We went to your brother Esau, and he's coming to meet you. With him are 400 men." Yaakov became greatly afraid and distressed. He divided the people, flocks, cattle, and camels with him into two camps. I said four, but it's really, it says two, but it's really four. Okay, so let's go back one slide.
Vamos a regresar una diapositiva.
And we're going to focus on verse 2 and 3.
Vamos a enfocarnos en versículos 2 y 3.
Because you got to look at the sequence of events.
Porque tiene que ver la secuencia de eventos.
Verse 2 and 3, versículo 2 y 3.
Versículo 2 y el 3.
Rugala. Yaakov went on his way, and the angels of God met him. When Yaakov saw them, he said, "This is God's camp," and called the place Machanaim, two camps. Okay, so before he freaks out.
So antes de que él se paniquea.
And he gets shown a sign.
Y le demuestran una señal, un prodigio.
The Lord is still trying to get Yaakov's attention.
El Señor todavía está tratando de tomarle la atención a Yaakov.
Because he needs to listen to the word of God instead of everything else around him to understand what's going on.
Porque él necesita escuchar la palabra de Dios en vez de lo que lo está rodeando para saber lo que está sucediendo.
So God knows what's going on in your head.
Dios sabe lo que está lo que ocurre en tu cabeza.
So here the Lord sends him a sign.
Aquí el Señor le envía una seña.
The angels of God met him.
El ángel de Dios se encontró con él.
So let's just take the simplest.
Los ángeles de Dios se encontraron con él.
Let's just take the simplest concept.
Vamos a tomar el concepto más simple.
Okay, before you go meet your brother.
Antes de que te vayas a encontrarte con tu hermano.
Before you make a plan to separate everything and give away half your belongings.
Antes de que te vayas a separar las tus cosas y entregar la mitad de tus propiedad.
The Lord says, my angels are with you.
El Señor te dice, mis ángeles están contigo.
So you don't have to do what you're thinking about.
So no tienes que hacer lo que estás pensando.
But when you can only see your problem and you can't see the redemption.
Cuando solamente puedes ver tu problema y no puedes ver la redención.
And this is a great lesson to learn for what's going on in the nation of America right now.
Y esa es una gran lección para aprender con lo que está sucediendo ahora mismo en América.
And in other nations because of the fake coronavirus 19.
Y lo que está sucediendo en otras naciones por el virus falso del COVID-19.
Let's just say it's real.
Vamos a suponer que es real.
Right now in America, everything's beginning to get locked down.
Ahora en América todo está empezando a ser
stopped.
Detenido.
People are not going to work.
La gente no está yendo al trabajo.
People are working from home.
Hay gente que está trabajando desde sus casas.
Schools are closed, colleges are closed.
Las escuelas están cerradas, los colegios están cerrados.
So you might have a situation where you can only see your problem.
Tú tal vez tengas una situación a donde solamente puedes ver tu problema.
But you can't see God's hand or his servants that are around you.
Pero no puede ver la mano de Dios ni sus sirvientes que están a tu alrededor.
And this was the problem with Jacob.
Y este es un problema con Jacob.
Okay, let's look at verse 2 through 4. Five again.
Vamos a mirar versículos 2 al 5 nuevamente.
Jacob went on his way, and the angels of God met him. When Jacob saw them, he said, "This is God's camp, or Elohim's camp," and called the place Machanaim, two camps. Jacob sent messengers ahead of him, to Esau his brother, toward the land of Seir, the country of Edom, which with these instructions, "Here's what you are to say to my lord Esau. Your servant Jacob says, I have been living with Laban and have stayed until now." Amen?
Amen.
So, he sees the angels and says, "This is God's camp. This is Elohim's camp."
Él ve los ángeles y él dice, "Este es el campamento de Dios."
But he looks right past God's sovereign hand.
Pero él mira más allá de la mano soberana de Dios.
He lacks trust.
A él es falta de confianza.
Even though Jehovah gives him an incredible sign.
Aunque Jehová le dio tremenda seña,
before he separates everything to give to his brother,
antes de que él separó todo para entregárselo a su hermano,
and that's what a lot of people do here.
Y eso es lo que muchos hacen aquí hoy en día.
Yes, sir.
It's true.
It's interactive. It's Bible study.
It's true, es verdad. A lot of times we can't see 2 feet in front of us when we're bombarded with the trials and tribulations of just daily life. Sometimes, I mean, all we see is the things that are going wrong instead of seeing that, okay, these things are going wrong, but God's in control. God is the one who's taking you by the hand and leading you. And a lot of times we pull back from God because of fear and lack of trust.
The biggest thing is lack of trust, but say that in Spanish, please. Okay.
Es verdad lo que dice aquí es que muchas veces nosotros vemos nuestros problemas y no podemos ver dos pies delante de nosotros porque lo que vemos es el problema y se nos olvida de que Dios está en control y que la mano de Dios nos está guiando y nos está dirigiendo, pero nosotros a veces echamos para atrás y le jalamos la mano porque no tenemos esa confianza y el temor, y uno se apodera de nosotros.
Well, that's why we teach Yeshua and the Torah here.
Por eso que enseñamos a Yeshua y la Torah aquí.
Because eventually things are going to get tremendously horrible.
Porque eventualmente las cosas se van a empeorar.
For most of the world.
Para la mayor parte del mundo.
There is a thing in Revelation where Yeshua, the Messiah, opens up the fourth seal.
Hay un evento en Apocalipsis donde Yeshua el Mesías abre el cuarto sello.
And he kills a lot of Gentiles.
Y mueren muchos gentiles.
And I believe a lot of Jews are going to die also.
Y yo también creo que muchos judíos van a morir también.
But if you trust the word,
pero si confías en la palabra,
which the word is Yeshua,
que la palabra es Yeshua,
and you follow the same book that Yeshua followed,
y si sigues el mismo libro que Yeshua siguió,
you will be saved.
Vas a ser salvo.
Because there's promises in the word.
Porque hay promesas en la palabra. Amen.
You know, I got a call, or you know, we're sitting here at Bible study.
Estamos sentados aquí en el estudio bíblico.
And I got a call earlier at it was 10:30. 10:30 this morning.
Era las 10:30 esta mañana.
And we rent a part of a commercial building.
Rentamos parte de un edificio comercial.
And I got a call from the manager of the building.
Y me llamó el gerente del edificio.
Saying that the county that our building is in,
el condado a donde existe nuestro edificio,
had an executive order,
tuvo una orden ejecutiva,
and that we were not supposed to meet.
Y que no estábamos supuestos reunirnos.
So I said, I read the order from the governor and it doesn't say that.
Yo le dije que yo leí la orden del gobernador y no dice eso.
So the manager says, well, you want to call the fire department?
Pero tú quieres, el gerente dijo, ¿tú quieres llamar a los bomberos, al departamento de bomberos?
You want to call the county executive? Go ahead.
¿Quieres llamar al ejecutivo del condado?
So I did.
So lo llamé.
But first I prayed.
Pero primero oré.
Because this ministry is not mine.
Porque este ministerio no es mío.
I trust my father.
Yo confío en mi padre.
I work for my father.
Yo trabajo para mi padre.
Amen. So I called the county executive.
So yo llamé al ejecutivo del condado.
I'm still waiting for a call back from him.
Todavía estoy esperando que me regrese la llamada.
But I called the fire person.
Llamé al jefe de los bomberos.
And I said, you know, I read what the governor wrote, Murphy, who's an idiot.
Yo leí lo que dijo Murphy, que es un idiota, el gobernador.
He's, you know, he's Catholic. What do you expect
él es
from
católico,
a Catholic?
¿Qué tú esperas de los
católicos? They don't know anything about the word of God.
Ellos no conocen nada de la palabra de Dios.
So, but, you know, they want to have everybody not meet. I said, during times of crisis.
Ellos no quieren que la gente se reúnan. Y yo le dije, durante tiempos de crisis.
We need to go to our churches. We need to go to our synagogues.
Necesitamos ir a nuestras iglesias, a nuestras sinagogas.
We need to draw closer to God, not further away from
debemos
God.
Debemos de acercarnos más a Dios y no alejarnos de Dios.
So the fire guy goes, I agree with you.
Y so el jefe de los bomberos dijo, estoy de acuerdo contigo.
So let me call the county executive and I'll get back to you.
Y dijo, déjame llamar al ejecutivo del condado y yo te llamo para atrás.
So I sat in my office chair at home.
So me senté en la silla de mi oficina en mi casa.
And I prayed to the Father.
Y le oré al Padre.
And I prayed to Yeshua.
Y le oré a Yeshua.
And I asked for guidance from the Holy Spirit.
Y pedí dirección del Espíritu Santo.
And I said, this doesn't seem like it's from you.
Esto no parece que es de ti.
Because they were going to stop Shabbat also.
Porque ellos iban a detener el Shabbat también.
So I was going to get arrested on Shabbat.
So me iban a arrestar el Shabbat.
I'm going to change my name to Kepha.
Iba a llamar, cambiar mi nombre a Kepha.
Because, you know, you got to count it as a joy to be beaten before the Lord.
Porque tienes que contarlo como gozo ser castigado por el Señor.
So the fire
Andrés Pedro.
The fire guy calls me back about a half hour later.
El bombero me llama como media hora después.
And he says he's been on the phone all this time with all these people. He's like, it's crazy.
El estado en el teléfono con tanta gente está una locura aquí.
He says, no, as long as you're not over 50 people, you can meet.
Si no tiene más de 50 personas, puede reunirte.
So that's why we're here.
They brought it down to 10. I'm just letting you know.
I'm still going to meet here.
Amen. No,
but I'm still going to have Shabbat.
I'm just saying that they brought it down to 10.
I didn't see that in any of the papers.
I think I sent the last one to you.
No, it was 4 people, but that was for business. It has nothing. It says
right.
I have it right in front of me.
Yeah, it says nothing about places of worship.
Yeah. Because the fire guy said it's for businesses. They closed the mall.
Right.
Well, good thing I don't go to the mall.
I forgot to go to Journeys. Dag.
Okay. So, why are we talking about this?
¿Por qué estamos hablando sobre esto?
Because we got to trust God's word no matter what.
Porque tenemos que confiar en la palabra de Dios no importa qué.
So, Yaakov here in verse 2 and 3.
So Jacob aquí en versículos 2 y 3.
The angels of God met him.
Los ángeles de Dios se encontraron con él.
He sees them.
Él los ve.
He says, this is Elohim's camp.
Él dice que este es el campamento de Elohim.
But then he just goes right back to his problem.
Pero entonces él regresa a su problema.
Of giving away, he wants to, you know, he thinks his brother's going to kill him.
Él piensa que su hermano lo va a matar.
All right. So let's go to the next slide.
So vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
So let's read verse 6 through 8 again.
Vamos a leer versículos 6 al 8 nuevamente.
Genesis, Bereshit 32, verse 6 through 8.
Génesis capítulo 32, versículos 6 al 8.
I have cattle, donkeys, flocks, and male and female servants. I'm sending to tell you this news to my Lord in order to win your favor. The messengers returned to Yaakov saying, We went to your brother Esau, and he's coming to meet you. With him are 400 men. Yaakov became greatly afraid and distressed. He divided the people, flocks, cattle, and camels with him into 2 camps. Amen.
Amen.
So he immediately forgets about the angels.
So inmediatamente se olvida de los ángeles.
He immediately forgets about Jehovah Elohim's promise.
Inmediatamente se le olvida de la promesa de Jehovah Elohim.
He goes right back to focusing on thinking his brother is going to kill him.
Él regresa en enfocarse que su hermano lo va a matar.
Now, do you think God would send angels, give you a vision of angels?
¿Tú crees que Dios te dará una visión de ángeles?
And then kill you?
¿Y después matarte?
And then if the angels are there,
los ángeles estaban ahí.
Well, if you're going to die, then you're going to go up to heaven, right?
Sí. Si vas a morir, vas a llegar al cielo, ¿sí o no?
You know, well, why would he send these angels?
¿Por qué él va a enviar a esos ángeles?
So Yaakov is very afraid.
Yaakov es muy temeroso.
He does not trust Jehovah Elohim's word.
Él no confía en la palabra de Jehovah Elohim.
Now, why could that be?
¿Por qué puede ser eso?
One, he doesn't trust.
Uno, no confía.
But the other part is he's got a guilty conscience.
Pero la otra parte es que él se siente culpable. Tiene una conciencia mala.
He did buy the birthright.
Él compró la primogenitura.
He did buy it from his brother.
Él lo compró de su hermano.
But he then tricked his father.
Pero entonces engañó a su padre.
Into blessing him.
En bendecirlo a él.
So he still has a guilty conscience.
So todavía tiene mala conciencia.
For 20 years he hasn't seen his brother.
Por 20 años no ha visto a su hermano.
So now he knows he didn't receive the blessing properly.
Él sabe que él no recibió el bendición correctamente.
Had he just told his father Yitzhak,
si le hubiera dicho a su padre Yitzhak,
I bought the blessing, the birthright from Esau.
Y le compré la primogenitura a Esaú.
Then the father could have said, okay, I'm going to bless you.
Y el padre podría haber dicho, okay, te voy a bendecir.
Because Esau didn't care.
Porque Esaú no le importó.
But when you have a guilty conscience,
cuando tienes mala conciencia,
you drop things.
Opa, se te caen las cosas.
You worry about things.
Te preocupas sobre las cosas.
You overreact to things.
Sobre reaccionas.
You don't think about what you're doing.
No piensas en lo que estás haciendo.
And Jacob is doing this.
Y Jacob está haciendo esto.
So let's focus now on verse number 8.
Vamos a enfocarnos ahora en el versículo número 8.
Jacob became greatly afraid and distressed.
Jacob.
He divided the people, flocks, cattle, and camels with him into two camps. So he hears his brothers coming at him with 400 men.
So él escucha que su hermano viene hacia él con 400 hombres.
He's like, I'm going to die.
Él dice, voy a morir.
And he's going to kill all my family.
Me va a matar a mi familia.
But then he doesn't trust in the promises of Jehovah.
Entonces él no confía en las promesas de Jehovah.
So he becomes greatly afraid and distressed. We're going to look at those two words.
So se vuelve bien temeroso y tiene mucho miedo. Ansiedad. Ansiedad y miedo.
Let's go to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
Let's read verse 8 again.
Leamos el versículo 8 nuevamente. Thank you.
Jacob became greatly afraid and distressed. He divided the people, flocks, cattle, and camels with him into two camps. Amen?
Amen.
So let's see what the Hebrew root word means for afraid and distressed.
Vamos a ver lo que la palabra raíz hebrea es para miedo y ansiedad.
Because remember, 20 years ago,
acuérdate, 20 años atrás,
when Jacob left,
cuando Jacob se fue,
he had Jacob's ladder. Remember, the angels met him on the way there.
Él tuvo el sueño de la escalera de Jacob.
And now the angels are meeting him on the way back.
Y ahora los ángeles se encontraron con él al regreso.
That would give me, you know, great security.
Eso me daría a mí gran seguridad.
But right after he meets the angels again, the second time,
pero la segunda vez que se encuentra con los ángeles,
and his father-in-law didn't kill him, Laban didn't kill him,
y su suegro no lo mató.
He gave him a blessing.
Le dio una bendición. Lo bendijo.
Now he hears his brothers coming. I mean, you see the lack of trust.
Ahora puedes ver la falta de confianza.
So he becomes afraid and distressed.
So se vuelve, tiene miedo y está ansioso.
The word afraid is H3372.
La palabra miedo es H3372.
It is the root word yare.
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 Es la palabra raíz
yare.
It means number one, to fear.
Significa número uno, temer.
Be afraid.
Tener miedo.
Number two, to be fearful.
Ser temeroso.
Be dreadful.
Estar atemorizado. Thank you.
Okay, so let's pause and look at these two words for a moment.
Vamos a pausar y mirar estas dos palabras por un momento.
So, he's afraid, so he's fearful.
Tiene miedo, está temeroso.
But then the one that... that we needed a little help on there. He's dreadful.
Atemorizado.
He thinks he's going to die.
Él piensa que va a morir.
He thinks he's going to die.
Piensa que va a morir.
Because he does not trust in the promises.
Porque él no confía en las promesas.
Jacob is afraid to die.
Jacob tiene miedo a morir.
That's why I don't care about this virus. It's not real, but I don't care about it.
Por eso que no me molesta este virus, porque yo sé que no es real.
Because only a whopping 52 people in America have died so far.
Porque solamente 52 personas en América han muerto. Yep.
52 people.
52 personas.
And they're doing all this.
Y están haciendo todo esto.
Can anybody say? No, I won't say it. Okay. But Jacob has a... coronavirus.
No.
Come from my plastic bucket. Now that was a funny video. Right here is my corona stick. My coronavirus stick. My 10-foot pole. Back. Nothing gets through plastic. All right. All right. So he becomes afraid, meaning he's dreadful, thinking his brother's going to kill him.
Se vuelve atemorizado porque él piensa que su hermano lo va a matar.
So he's not trusting that Jehovah said, your descendants are going to be numerous.
So él no está confiando en la promesa que Jehovah le dio que sus descendientes iban a ser numerosos.
Now there's two descriptive words here.
Hay dos palabras descriptivas.
Because he became greatly afraid and distressed.
Porque él tuvo mucho miedo y tenía ansiedad. Angustiado.
Okay. So distress is age 6887.
Angustiado es 6887.
It is the root word sarar.
Es la palabra raíz sarar.
It means number one, be in distress.
Estar angustiado.
Besiege, like you're an army is coming at you. They're besieging you.
Están sobre. ¿Te están apoderando?
Look it up. Un momento, we're going to look it up.
Come on. This thing is so slow.
You have not shut up. I don't know how you're listening. You have not, you are constantly talking. I don't know how you're listening to the study. We're looking up
cercar,
a word.
Cercar? Encercar?
Besiege?
Encercar.
Encercar. Okay. The other word you're going to need to look up is vex.
Vex?
V-E-X.
Oh, God. Where is it? Right here. Okay. Irritar.
Okay.
Irritar.
So we got those two words.
We got those two words.
Because we're going to talk about those two words.
Oh boy. So the other one was encercar y irritar.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. So he's not only afraid.
Él no solamente tiene miedo.
He's not only dreadful.
Él no solamente está atemorizado.
He is in distress.
Él está angustiado.
He's besieged by this distress.
Está
like overcoming.
Él está encercado por esta angustia.
He's being vexed by this distress.
Él está siendo irritado por esta angustia.
Not vexed, but vexed.
Right.
Okay. So, all because he doesn't trust in the promises of Jehovah.
Solamente porque él no confía en las promesas de Jehovah.
Jehovah said, I'll bless you.
Jehovah dijo, te bendeciré.
And everything you prayed when you left your father's house has been given to him.
Y todo lo que has pedido en oración desde que te fuiste de tu casa de tu padre, se te ha entregado.
And it was an obnoxious prayer.
Y era una oración.
It's a horrible prayer. Arrogant prayer.
Arrogante.
Okay.
Fue una oración arrogante.
You know, if you keep me safe and feed me and clothe me, then I'll give you 10%.
Si tú me guardas y me da de comer y me da de vestir, te doy 10%.
So everything you prayed for, you got.
Todo lo que has orado, ha pedido en oración, se te ha recibido.
Now you think your brother is still mad at you after 20 years.
Ahora piensas que tu hermano todavía está enojado contigo después de 20 años.
Don't you think the guy grew up already?
¿No crees que él ya ha madurado?
You know, he's got his own life. Maybe he's got his own family.
Él tiene su propia vida. Tal vez tiene su propia familia.
But I'm still going to kill my brother.
Yo todavía voy a matar a mi hermano.
For something he did 20 years ago.
Porque me quebró mi Nintendo.
See, when you grow up, you take responsibility. Some people take responsibility.
Cuando maduras, hay algunos que toman responsabilidad.
You know, when you were a kid, you know. You did some things to your siblings.
Cuando era niño, le hiciste algo a tus hermanos.
And then When you're older, you're like, yeah, I really broiled you that time.
Cuando ya te maduras, te recuerdas del momento y te ríes.
So, if human nature is still the same,
si la naturaleza humana todavía es igual,
and we're seeing that human nature,
I need batteries.
Okay. Rabbi Ed, would you? These are new, so. Thank you, sir. So, oh, wait, we got to wait for the translator battery. One second.
Okay.
But when you have a guilty conscience,
cuando tienes mala conciencia,
you think that other people think just like you.
Tú piensas que otros piensan igual que tú.
But Esau grew up and Yaakov did not.
Pero Esaú maduró y Jacob no.
They have families of their own.
Tenían familias propias.
I'm stuck. Stuck in the chair. And so here he gets greatly afraid and distressed because he does not trust.
So aquí él tiene mucho miedo y está angustiado porque no confía.
Let's go on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
Let's now look at verse 10 through 12.
Ahora vamos a ver versículos 10 al 12.
Then Yaakov said, Elohim of my father, Abraham, and Elohim of my father, Yitzhak, Jehovah who told me, return to your country and your kinsmen, and I will do you good. I'm not worthy of all the love and faithfulness you have shown your servant since I've crossed the Jordan with only my staff, but now I've become two camps. Please rescue me from my brother Esau. I'm afraid of him, afraid he'll come and attack me without regard for his mothers or children. Amen?
Amen.
So here we're, now he finally prays to the Lord.
Finalmente él está orando al Señor.
And he says to the Lord,
y él le dice al Señor,
you're the one who told me to go back.
Tú eres que me dijiste que regresara.
So do you really think the God of promises is sending you back to kill you?
So tú crees que el Dios de promesa te está diciendo que regrese para que te mate?
Once again, we're seeing lack of trust.
Nuevamente estamos viendo falta de confianza.
Okay. And he says in verse 10 again, let's read verse 10.
Él está diciendo en el versículo 10, nuevamente vamos a leerlo.
Let's read verse 10.
Vamos a leer el versículo 10.
Yaakov said, Elohim of my father, Abraham, and Elohim my father, Yitzhak, Jehovah told me to return, Jehovah who told me, return to your country and kinsmen, I will do you good. Amen?
Amen.
So he's saying that God told him, return and I'm going to do you good.
Él está diciendo que Dios le dijo que regresara y que yo te voy a hacer bien.
Why are you not trusting that promise?
¿Por qué tú no estás confiando en esa promesa?
You're worrying about your brother.
Estás preocupado de tu hermano.
Who sold you the birthright?
Que te vendió su primogenitura.
But you have a promise from Jehovah and you're stating it here in verse 10.
Tienes una promesa de Jehová y lo está declarando aquí en el versículo 10.
This is where we need to learn this lesson for ourselves.
Aquí es donde necesitamos aprender esta lección para nosotros mismos.
Jehovah has plans for all of us.
Jehovah tiene planes para todito nosotros.
To do good for us.
Para hacer bien para nosotros.
If we follow his plan.
Si seguimos su plan.
But here, let's now look at verse 12.
Pero vamos a ver el versículo 12.
Please rescue me from my brother Esau. I'm afraid of him, afraid he'll come and attack me without regard for mothers or children. Okay, so in verse 12,
so versículo 12
is a contradiction to verse 10.
Es una contradicción de versículo 10.
Because in verse 10 he said that Jehovah said, I'm going to do you good.
Porque en el versículo 10 él dice que yo te voy a hacer bien.
In verse 12 he's saying, rescue me.
Y en el versículo 12 él está diciendo rescátenme.
Then how is God going to do you good if he's going to allow your brother to kill you?
¿Cómo Dios te va a hacer bien si él va a permitir que tu hermano te mate?
Isn't it a contradiction?
¿No es una contradicción?
It seems to me that it's a contradiction.
Para mí suena como es una contradicción.
Because Let's look at verse 12 again.
Pues vamos a mirar el versículo 12 nuevamente.
Please rescue me from my brother Esau. I'm afraid of him, and he'll come and attack me without regard for mothers or children. So he's afraid of Yaakov is afraid of Esau.
Jacob le tiene miedo a Esau.
But he's not trusting in God.
Pero él no está confiando en Dios.
You're not afraid of God, but you're afraid of your brother.
No le tiene miedo a Dios, pero le tiene miedo a tu hermano.
But then it really shows his personality.
Pero en verdad demuestra su personalidad.
At the second half of the sentence.
En la segunda parte de la oración, del versículo.
How does it show his personality?
¿Cómo es que demuestra su personalidad?
Because he says he's going to come and attack me, and he's not going to worry about the mothers or the children.
Porque dice que me va a atacar a mí y no está preocupado de las madres y los niños.
So, what is this showing?
So, ¿qué demuestra esto?
He's lacking trust.
Falta de confianza.
The key is, why would this man who's been blessed so heavily,
la razón es la de la
so
clave,
much,
de la clave que ha sido tan bendecido.
Why would he lack trust?
¿Por qué tendría falta de confianza?
Because he has not repented yet.
Porque no se ha arrepentido todavía.
He's never going to repent.
Y tampoco se va a arrepentir.
About lying to his father.
De mentirle a su padre.
And when you have that inside you.
Y cuando tienes eso por dentro.
On the outside you can look like you're trusting.
Afuera puedes demostrar que estás confiando.
But then when the flame gets turned up a little bit.
Pero cuando se sube la llama.
This is where your lack of trust will be evident.
Esto a donde tu falta de confianza va a ser evidente.
And he's supposedly worried about his children when he's really not.
Supuestamente él está preocupado de sus hijos cuando en verdad él no lo es.
Because he first says he's going to attack me.
Porque primero dice que me va a atacar a mí.
Why would he want to kill your wives and your children?
¿Por qué él quisiera matar a tus esposas y tus hijos?
Did you? He's your twin brother.
Él es tu gemelo.
I mean, maybe you know him a little bit.
Tal vez tú lo conoces un poco.
But you grew up with the same parents.
Te criaste con los mismos padres.
Okay. So we see that he lacks trust.
Vemos que él es falta de confianza.
Let's take a look in the scriptures to get a better picture of the word trust.
Vamos a mirar el imagen para tener un entendimiento de la palabra confianza.
Hold your place there in Genesis.
Mantén tu lugar ahí en Génesis.
We're going to look at the diamond now for the word trust.
Vamos a mirar el diamante ahora para la palabra confianza.
Turn to Psalm 56.
Vamos al Salmo 56.
Psalm 56.
Salmo 56.
Verse 3 and 4.
Versículos 3 y 4.
Psalm 56, verse 3 and 4.
Salmo 56, versículos 3 y 4.
Psalm 56, verse 3 and 4.
Salmo 56.
Open up your phones.
56, versículos 3 al 4. Abran sus teléfonos y sus tabletas.
Psalm 56, verse 3 and 4.
Salmo 56, versículos 3 y 4.
When I am afraid, I put my trust in you. In Elohim, I praise his word. In Elohim, I trust. I have no fear. What can human power do to me?
Amen.
Okay? This is what Yaakov is not doing.
Esto es lo que Jacob no está haciendo.
Because we saw very clearly that he became afraid and distressed.
Porque vimos claramente que él tuvo miedo y estaba angustiado.
Let's take a look at the word trust in the Hebrew.
Vamos a mirar la palabra confianza en el hebreo.
So that we can understand what the psalmist David is writing.
Para poder entender qué está escribiendo el salmista David aquí.
The word trust is H982.
La palabra confianza es H982.
It is the root word batak.
Es la palabra raíz batak.
It means number one, to trust.
Significa uno, confiar.
Number two, to trust in.
Confiar en.
Number three, to have confidence in or be confident.
Tener confianza o ser confidente.
Number four, to be secure.
Número cuatro, estar seguro.
Number five, to feel safe.
Y número cinco, sentirse seguro.
Let's look at verse 3 and 4 again. Let's look at verse 3 and 4.
Vamos a mirar versículos 3 y 4.
When I'm afraid, I put my trust in you. In Elohim, I praise his word. In Elohim, I trust. I have no fear. What can human power do to me? Do to me. Okay? I'm not afraid.
No tengo miedo.
Because I trust.
Porque yo confío.
I have confidence.
Tengo confianza.
I'm secure.
Estoy seguro.
In the word.
En la palabra.
Once that happens.
Ya cuando eso suceda.
Not that you shouldn't prepare for some problems.
No que no debes de prepararte o estar preparado para problemas.
But it's the worry part that a lot of people are doing.
Es la parte de preocuparse. Que muchos están haciendo.
When you look at the videos of the people fighting over the toilet paper.
Cuando miras a los videos de la gente peleando por el papel higiénico.
There was fear in their eyes.
Había temor en sus ojos.
There was no confidence in the system.
No había confianza en el sistema.
They didn't feel safe.
No se sentían seguros.
But and this is the same for Yaakov.
Y esto es lo mismo para Yaakov.
He was afraid of his brother.
Él temía a su hermano.
He didn't feel safe.
No se sentía seguro.
He didn't feel secure.
No se sentía seguro.
So he had fear.
Se tenía miedo.
But here, we're not to have that fear. We're to learn this lesson from the Word.
Pero aquí no debemos de tener ese miedo. Debemos de aprender de esta palabra.
Let's go to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
Let's turn to Proverbs 3, verse 5 and 6.
Vamos a Proverbios, capítulo 3, versículos 5 y 6.
Proverbs 3.
Proverbios, capítulo 3,
verse 5 and 6.
Versículos 5 y 6.
Open up your phone.
Abran sus ojos, sus teléfonos, sus tabletas.
To Proverbs, Michelle 3, verse 5 and 6.
A Proverbios, capítulo 3, versículos 5 y 6.
Trust in Yehovah with all your heart. Do not rely on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, then he will level your paths. So let's take this lesson to Yaakov.
So vamos a llevar esta lección a Yaakov.
Did he rely on his own understanding or did he trust in his heart?
¿Será que él dependió de su propio entendimiento okay.
He was relying on his own understanding.
Él estaba dependiendo de su propio entendimiento.
He thought his brother was going to kill him.
Él pensaba que su hermano lo iba a matar.
But the Lord is saying, trust me.
Pero el Señor está diciendo, confía en mí.
Trust my word.
Él está diciendo, confía en mi palabra.
Trust my Messiah, Yeshua.
Confía en mi Mesías, Yeshua.
See, Yaakov was not acknowledging Jehovah in all of his ways.
Yaakov no estaba reconociendo a Jehovah en todos sus caminos.
So here, his path was not level. It was on rocky ground.
So aquí su camino no estaba anivelado. Estaba en camino rocoso.
So here, for 20 years, he thinks his brother is going to kill him.
So aquí por 20 años él piensa que su hermano lo va a matar.
But he wasn't trusting Jehovah with all his heart.
Pero él no estaba confiando en Jehovah con todo su corazón.
It's a perfect lesson for what's going on here in America.
Es una lección perfecta por lo que está sucediendo aquí en
America. I love how the Lord works out His plan.
A mí me encanta cómo el Señor trabaja su plan.
Because here we're studying this parasha when the world is not.
Porque aquí estamos estudiando este parasha ya cuando el mundo no lo está haciendo.
Let's go to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
Turn to the Gospel of Mark, chapter 11.
Vamos al Evangelio de Marco, capítulo 11, versículo 24.
Mark, chapter 11, verse 24.
Marco, capítulo 11, versículo 24.
Mark chapter 11 verse 24.
Marcos capítulo 11 versículo 24.
Open up your tablet to Mark 11 verse 24.
Abran sus tabletas y sus teléfonos a Marcos capítulo 11 versículo 24.
Got it. Got it. Say amen.
Amen.
It's easier on your phone.
It opened up.
Therefore I tell you, whatever you ask for in prayer, trust that you are receiving it, and it will be yours.
Amen.
So here we have another promise from Yeshua the Messiah.
Aquí tenemos una promesa de Yeshua el Mesías.
In the Brit Hadashah, the New Testament.
En el Brit Hadashah, el Nuevo Testamento.
That if you're asking for something in accordance with God's word.
Que si estás pidiendo algo que está de acuerdo con la palabra de Dios.
Trust that you're going to receive it.
Confía que lo vas a recibir.
So if Jehovah sends angels to surround you.
So si Jehová envía ángeles que te rodeen.
Don't worry, you know, Esau is not going to kill you.
No te preocupes que Esaú no te va a matar.
You can have confidence that you're going to live.
Puedes tener confianza que vas a vivir.
You can feel safe that God is going to be with you.
Puedes estar seguro que Dios va a estar contigo.
And you're not going to wrestle with the word of God.
Y no vas a luchar con la palabra de Dios.
Let's go to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
Let's turn to Philippians 4.
Vamos a Filipenses capítulo 4.
Philippians 4 verse 6 and 7.
Filipenses capítulo 4 versículos 6 y 7.
Philippians 4 verse 6 and 7.
Filipenses 4, versículos 6 y 7.
Philippians 4, verse 6 and 7. It's all about trust.
Filipenses, capítulo 4, versículos 6 y 7. Esto se trata de confianza.
Don't worry about anything. On the contrary, make your requests known to God by prayer and petition with thanksgiving. Then God's shalom, passing all understanding, will keep your hearts and minds safe in union with the Messiah, Yeshua.
Amen.
Okay, so Yaakov was definitely not doing this.
Yaakov definitivamente no estaba haciendo esto.
He was worried about everything.
Él estaba preocupado de todo.
Because he wasn't trusting in the promises of the Lord.
Porque no estaba confiando en las promesas del Señor.
Do we think Yaakov had any shalom?
¿Pensamos que Yaakov tuvo shalom?
No.
No.
And if you talk to people right now,
y si hablas con la gente ahora,
about this coronavirus,
de este virus de corona,
are they going to have any shalom?
¿Van a tener shalom?
No.
No.
But we the followers of Yeshua and Torah should.
Nosotros los seguidores de Yeshua y la Torah debemos de tener.
See, if you don't worry about anything,
si no te preocupas de nada,
if you're trusting in God,
si confías en Dios,
then His shalom that passes all understanding is going to be yours.
Entonces, su shalom que sobrepasa todo entendimiento va a ser tuyo.
So what's the lesson that we learn from Yaakov?
So ¿cuál es la lección que podemos aprender de Yaakov?
He had absolutely no shalom.
Él no tuvo absolutamente nada de shalom.
His mind was not safe at this point in this parasha.
Su mente no estaba seguro aquí en este punto, en este parasha.
So what transpires after this?
So lo que transcurre después de esto.
This is one of the reasons that these things happen.
Esto es una de las razones por qué sucedió esto.
Because when you don't trust,
porque cuando no confías,
when you don't listen to the study,
cuando no escuchas el estudio,
then God will distance himself from you.
Entonces Dios se aleja de ti.
And the farther God gets away from you, farther God gets away from you,
entre más Dios se aleja de ti,
the more problems can get between you and God.
Ahí es que más problemas pueden venir entre tú y Dios.
Let's go to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
Let's go back to Bereshit 32.
Regresemos a Bereshit, a Génesis capítulo 32.
We're going to read verse 24 to 31.
Vamos a leer versículos 32
verse 24 through 31.
32 versículos 24 al 31. Sorry.
Chapter 32, verse 24 to 31.
Capítulo 32, versículos 24 al 31.
Genesis 32, verse 24 to 31.
Génesis, capítulo 32, versículos 24 al 31.
He took them and sent them across the stream. Then he sent his possessions across. And Yaakov was left alone. Then some man wrestled with him until daybreak. When he saw that he did not defeat Yaakov, he struck Yaakov's hip socket, so his hip was dislocated while wrestling with him. The man said, "Let me go because it's daybreak." But Yaakov replied, "I won't let you go unless you bless me." Next slide. Then the man asked, "What is your name?" And he answered, "Yaakov." Then the man said, "From now on, you will no longer be called Yaakov, but Israel, because you've shown your strength to both God and men, and have prevailed." Yaakov asked him, "Please tell me your name." But he answered, "Why are you asking about my name?" He blessed him there. Yaakov called the place Peniel, face of God, because I've seen God face to face, and my life is spared. Amen?
Amen.
So let's go back one slide.
Vamos a regresar una diapositiva.
In verse number 25,
en versículo número 25,
24, sorry.
Disculpa, el 24.
We see that Yaakov is still not trusting.
Vemos que Yaakov todavía no está confiando.
He sends everything ahead of him and he's there alone.
Él envía todo por por adelante de él y and then what?
He's alone.
Y él está solo.
Then in verse 25,
y entonces en el versículo 25,
let's read verse 25.
Vamos a leer el versículo 25.
And Yaakov was left alone. Then some man wrestled with him until daybreak. Okay? Some guy pops out of nowhere.
Algún varón sale de la nada.
Just out of nowhere, this guy pops up.
De la nada, del aire sale este hombre.
And then he wrestles with this guy all night long.
Y lucha con este hombre la noche entera.
All night long.
La noche entera.
In the dark.
En la oscuridad.
He's wrestling with this guy.
Él está luchando con este hombre.
This guy who's going to change son of the promise's name.
Este varón que le va a cambiar el nombre al hijo de la promesa.
So let's now look at verse 27.
Vamos ahora a mirar el versículo 27.
The man said, "Let me go because it's daybreak." But Yaakov replied, "I won't let you go until you bless, unless you bless me." Why is he asking for this guy for a blessing?
¿Por qué él está pidiendo una bendición de este varón?
This is a very good verse to use on Orthodox Jews who don't know Yeshua yet.
Este es un versículo bien bueno para usar en los judíos ortodoxos que todavía no conocen a Yeshua el Mesías.
Because who's this guy that Yaakov wants a blessing from?
Porque ¿quién es este quien Yaakov le está pidiendo una bendición?
You know, the guy pops out of nowhere.
El varón sale de la nada.
He starts to wrestle with Yaakov.
Comienza a luchar con Yaakov.
See, when you don't trust God,
ves, cuando no confías en Dios,
Jehovah will then send you more challenges.
Jehovah te enviará más desafíos.
Let's go to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
Verse 28.
Versículo 28.
The man asked, "What is your name?" And he answered, "Yaakov." So now we know that it is Yaakov that's wrestling.
Sabemos ahora que el que está luchando con el varón es Yaakov.
It's a very important verse.
Es un versículo bien importante.
Because you have to know who that it is Yaakov that's wrestling with this man.
Porque tienes que saber que es Yaakov que está luchando con este varón.
We're not going to go into Israel wrestling with Messiah.
No vamos a entrar a Israel luchando con el Mesías.
But here in verse 29,
aquí en el versículo 29,
the man said, "From now on, you will no longer be called Yaakov, but Israel, because you have shown your strength to both God and men and have prevailed. How does this guy know God?
¿Cómo es que este varón conoce a Dios?
And who is somebody that the Father is going to allow to change the Son of the Promise's name?
¿Y quién es el que el Padre va a permitir que le cambie el nombre al Hijo de la Promesa?
Okay, now we've gone into other studies on the web. We go into who this man is. It's Yeshua. It's the Messiah.
Tenemos otros estudios en la red de quién es varón y sabemos que Yeshua es el Mesías.
But why is he wrestling?
Pero ¿por qué él está luchando?
Because he's not trusting.
Porque no está confiando.
When you don't trust the word of God, you wrestle.
Cuando no confías en la palabra de Dios, luchas.
When you don't want to do all the law and you only want to do parts of the law.
Cuando no quieres cumplir con toda la ley, solamente parte de la ley.
You wrestle with God.
Está luchando con Dios.
You wrestle with Messiah.
Está luchando con Mesías.
Let's go to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
Let's take a look at wrestling.
Vamos a mirar la palabra luchar.
Or struggling.
Oh.
You're going to need that word.
Yours is faster than mine, I think.
Struggling.
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 We're struggling to find the word struggling. We are struggling to find the word struggling. Luchar, esforzarse. Esfuerzo.
Okay, turn to Ephesians 6, verse 12.
Vamos a Efesios capítulo 6, versículo 12.
Ephesians 6, verse 12.
Efesios capítulo 6, versículo 12.
It's so nice. Building is so quiet. No helicopters overhead.
No music downstairs. No boom, boom, boom downstairs.
No boom, boom, boom. Ephesians 6, verse 12. Another 5 or 10 more minutes, everybody.
Efesios 6, versículo 12.
For we are not struggling against human beings, but against rulers, authorities, and cosmic powers governing this darkness, against spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realm. Now the word struggle in the Greek,
la palabra luchar o esfuerzo en el griego,
is G3823.
Es G3823.
Number one, wrestling.
Número uno, luchar.
Throwing another person to the ground.
Tirar otra persona al suelo.
And putting your hand on their neck.
Y poner tu mano sobre su cuello.
So that they yield to you.
Para que se rindan a ti.
So what do we draw from this struggling reference? So
¿qué podemos sacar de esta referencia de luchar o de
The key to Yaakov's struggle was internally.
La clave al esfuerzo de Jacob era
internally.
Interno.
See, that's where your main battle is.
Ahí es a donde está tu batalla principal.
And that's where Jacob's battle was.
Y ahí es a donde estaba la batalla de Jacob.
Because he wasn't struggling financially.
Porque no estaba luchando financieramente.
Even though he had four households to take care of.
Aunque tú tenía cuatro hogares para la cual mantener.
And now he's got 13 children.
Ahora tiene 13 hijos.
Because he's got Dinah. He also has Dinah also.
Y también tiene Dinah.
But he's not struggling financially.
Pero no está luchando financieramente.
He's struggling against the cosmic powers.
Él está luchando contra los poderes cósmicos.
When you don't trust, you struggle.
Cuando no confías, te cuesta, te luchas.
Let's go on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
Turn to Matthew 15.
Vamos a Mateo capítulo 15.
Matthew 15.
Mateo capítulo 15,
verse 22 to 28.
Versículos 22 al 28.
Now you can struggle for something good.
Ahora puedes luchar para algo bueno.
Now we're going to see struggling for something good.
Vamos a ver luchar por algo bueno.
Matthew 15, verse 22 to 28.
Mateo capítulo 15, versículos 22 al 28.
A woman from Canaan who was living there came to him pleading, "Sir, have pity on me, son of David. My daughter is cruelly held under the power of demons." But Yeshua did not say a word to her. Rude. Then his Talmudim came to him and urged him, "Send her away, because she is following us and keeps pestering us with her crying." He said, "I was only sent to that lost sheep of the house of Israel." But she came, fell at his feet, and said, "Sir, help me." He answered, "It is not right to take the children's food and toss it to their pet dogs." She said, "That's true, sir. But even the dogs eat the leftovers that fall from their master's table." Then Yeshua answered her, "Lady, you're a person with great trust. Let your desire be granted." And her daughter was healed at that very moment. So what was she doing?
Entonces, ¿qué es lo que ella estaba haciendo?
She was struggling to receive her blessing.
Ella estaba luchando para recibir su bendición.
She is willing to persevere.
Ella estaba dispuesta a perseverar.
Yaakov had the blessing.
Yaakov tenía la bendición.
And was not trusting.
Y no estaba confiando.
This Gentile woman was trusting because he said, "I've only come for the house of Israel."
Esta gentil estaba confiando, pero aunque él dijo que yo vine solo por la casa de Israel.
So she's a Gentile.
Ella es gentil.
So she struggled to receive the blessing from the word.
So ella luchó para recibir la bendición de la palabra.
And she came to Messiah to get the blessing.
Y ella vino a Mesías a recibir la bendición.
Let's go on the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima diapositiva.
Psalm 23.
Salmo 23.
Psalm 23, verse
Salmo 23.
3 through 6.
Versículos 3 al 6.
Psalm 23.
Salmo 23.
Verse 3 through 6.
Versículos 3 al 6.
He restores my soul. He guides me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and loving kindness will follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. See, when you trust,
cuando confías,
the Lord can prepare your table surrounded by your enemies.
El Señor puede preparar tu mesa rodeado de tus enemigos.
This is what Jacob was not doing.
Esto es lo que Jacob no estaba haciendo.
He was not trusting.
Él no estaba confiando.
He thought Esau was his enemy.
Él pensaba que Esaú era su enemigo.
And he was looking with his physical eyes instead of his spiritual eyes.
Él estaba mirando con sus ojos físicos en vez de mirar con sus ojos espirituales.
But here we are not to worry.
Pero aquí nosotros no debemos de preocuparnos.
Stop struggling with God.
Deja de estar luchando con Dios.
Next slide, we're done with today's study.
Terminamos con el estudio esta tarde.
Okay. Any questions in here or comments in here?
Hay preguntas o comentarios aquí. You ate my arugula.
All right, let's close in prayer.
Vamos a cerrar con un poco de oración.
Thank you, Lord, for your blessings today. Thank you, Lord, for this powerful word of trusting and wrestling. Let us not wrestle with your word anymore. Let us just do it. Let us trust that you are in command of all things. In your name, Yeshua, and everybody said, Amen. Shalom Aleichem.
Shalom. This is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman. I would personally like to thank you for tuning in to the Remnant's Call each and every week. You can listen to the full message on our website, bethgoyim.org. If you have drawn closer to the King of Kings, learned more about Him today, we are blessed. If you are blessed, by these messages, please consider a donation to our ministry. You can go to our website, bethgoyim.org. That's BETHGOYIM.org. And click on the donate button. You do not have to have a PayPal account to donate. All you need is a debit card. Once again, thank you very much for listening to The Remnant's Call.
If you have not taken your first steps to be born again, just ask God's help. Remember, it's His loving grace that has come to find you. No one is worthy or able to reach God, but God can reach us, and He's reaching out to you now. Just open your heart and let Him in. His arms are open, and the blessing of salvation and eternal life are waiting for you. Don't let it wait any longer.
Ya Adonai, panavodeka, vikuneka. Yisa Adonai, panavodeka, vayasem lecha, shalom. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift His face and shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you and give you His shalom.
Shalom, my name is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman, and I invite you to come to visit our congregation. If you are in the tri-state area, come out and visit with us on Shabbat. We are a congregation of Jews and Gentiles living as one in the Messiah Yeshua. BGMC is a place of true worship. The focus never wanders from the Hebraic roots of our faith. Beth Goyim is rooted in the Word of God from Bereshit through to the Book of Revelation. Messiah's strong words against man-made tradition are carefully recorded in Matthew 7. That is the reason we only follow the straight-up instructions found in Scripture, truly the way, the truth, and the life. If you're looking for a deeper walk with Adonai, come out for our Tuesday evening Bible study called Messianic Torah Time. Come, spend a day with us on any Shabbat. We start at 11 a.m. with the sound of the ancient Hebrew shofar. Next, we offer our King praise and worship in English, Hebrew, and Spanish. After worship, we review the headlines in the previous week's news from around the globe, especially news from the Holy Land Israel. We don't just list the news headlines as current events, but we comb through the scriptures, searching for clues to understand what they mean and then to help pinpoint prophetically our current position on Adonai's clock. After digesting all that modern information, we leave the world behind as we journey with our Adonai deep into His eternal word, not with just one or two scriptures, but usually seven or more scriptures. The spiritual nourishment and the richness of His kingdom become accessible to the ones who share this special time and seek them out. The day does not end there, because Shabbat is so special to Him. There is always so much more that our King desires to share. So instead of separating and leaving, we stay together as a family for potluck lunch and an afternoon study of our King's Word. We close the Shabbat together with a reading of the new week's parashah. That's the Torah portion. Even after those blessings, many of us just can't get enough. So the members bring prepared homemade foods to share while we all enjoy an uplifting movie together. If all that information is not quite enough, you can check out our website where you will find over 200 video teachings and biblical holy day studies. Under Messianic Torah Time, the Hebrew Roots button, you'll discover free studies on many, many different topics, including PowerPoint slide presentations. If Beth Goyim sounds like a place you'd love to visit, but you live outside the tri-state area, there is still a way to connect with us. We stream live on the internet on Tuesday, Thursday, and Shabbat. The website is www.bethgoyim.org. That's B-E-T-H
goyim.org. Our phone number is 973-338-7800 or 978-2-YESHUA. That's 978, the number 2, Yeshua. Shalom.